Fox Business Network's Charles Payne was giving a speech at the Freedom Center's 2013 Restoration Weekend. That it's basically just a business event. That's all you need to know about it. And he was talking about Social Security disability and the fraud rate in that program. Listen to what he says.
So you walk into the office and you're 27 years old and you're strong and robust and you say, oh, my back. They start writing you a check. Or you say, I just can't take it. This economy is so tough and I can't think straight. They cut you a check. So now these modern day units are being paid billions of dollars not to work. And on top of it, they brag about it. They're proud of it. And I'm going to tell you right now, woe to the mailman that shows up on the first of the month without somebody's crazy check.
First off, Charles Payne talking about fraud is hilarious because there was a report on June 24th of this year, quote, Charles Payne of Fox Business was compensated to promote stocks of at least three companies since joining Fox. The practice of compensated stock endorsements is currently prohibited by Fox rules and resulted in the recent contract termination of contributor Tobin Smith. Payne was paid $40,000 to promote the Brainy Brands company, $25,000 by a third party to promote NXT Nutritional Holdings, and an undisclosed amount for a consulting arrangement to promote Generex Biotechnology Corporate. Now, I should also add that he didn't disclose that he was paid to promote these products, and he presented them on the different shows as if this was his objective opinion as an analyst that people should invest in those companies when it wasn't. He was paid to promote those companies. And what ended up happening with the companies, quote, the share prices of the companies Payne was paid to tout are now essentially worthless. That, ladies and gentlemen, is fraud. Fraud is defined as the wrongful or criminal deception intended to result in financial or personal gain. So being paid to promote a product as if it is your objective opinion when it is not, that is fraud. It is deception that helped you financially. It helped you with personal gain. You are the person who is committing fraud, sir. So how dare you talk about Social Security disability and the fraud associated with that program. But even just the fact that he's mocking people who are on disability, he called them modern day eunuchs. You know what a eunuch is? It's a castrated man. So what, if somebody got hurt on the job and needs money to survive, they're a eunuch? It's like they got their dick and their balls chopped off by getting hurt? I don't even understand what that means. To me, it seems like he's just making like a dumbass, fake, macho thing to say. Like, yeah, I'm a strong guy, I don't get hurt, I always go to work, even if my left toe is hanging off. I'll fight through it. I don't care. I had the Ebola virus. I fought through it. Now, sometimes you get hurt. Sometimes, you know, you can't help it. You don't have the financial stability and you need a little bit of help from Social Security to survive. But these things are obvious. But more importantly, he's also dead wrong about fraud being this big problem. Because, quote, a fiscal year 2011 investigation by the Government Accountability Office found that improper payments of Social Security benefits that include disability insurance had an error rate of just 0.6%. 0.6% he's complaining about. A 0.6% error rate. Look, if you're in favor of shrinking government, which obviously Payne is, he talks about it all the time, instead of focusing on Social Security, why don't you focus on the elephant in the room, like defense spending? We spend more than the next 14 largest militaries combined. We have 900 military bases around the world. We still got the Bush Doctrine going on where we preemptively invade countries. I mean, we spent $7 trillion in Iraq when all is said and done by 2053. That's the problem. The problem is defense spending. The problem is corporate welfare. $4 billion subsidy check to ExxonMobil for no reason. Oh, we need it for research and development. No. You don't need an incentive to do research and development. Isn't being one of the most profitable corporations enough of an incentive to do your own goddamn research and development? But no, they never focus on the things that actually should be cut. They focus on you know, Social Security fraud. And look, it is a problem. Any fraud is a problem. But we have, you know, departments of the government working to limit the fraud. And unfortunately, guess what? The Republicans recently cut that program. So if anything, you should be telling your Republican buddies, if this is such a big problem to you, refund the department that checks for Social Security fraud.